countries are different, cultures are different, but when it comes to basic needs like using the toilet, we're all the same, right? Wrong. Hello, servus, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Felicia. I'm originally from Munich, Germany, but have been living here in Cincinnati, Ohio, off and on since 2016. And on my channel, I talk about differences between the US and Germany. So if you followed my channel for a while, you know that my videos are usually a little longer and pretty in-depth. Sometimes they just cover a single topic, and sometimes they're lists. But for a while now, I've had this note on my phone with a bunch of, yeah, I kind of call them random differences between the two countries that I couldn't really fit into a broader topic or into a list, and that at first sight also don't really seem to have a reasonable explanation as to why that's different in Germany and the US. So I've decided to make a little series out of this with videos that are a little shorter than usually and that are each dedicated to one of those topics. So today is the first one about peeing. We'll get to that in a second. And in the next few days, I'll be releasing one video, one topic every other day. So if you're not a subscriber yet, make sure to subscribe to my channel for free, then activate the bell and also activate the notifications in your YouTube settings. And that way you won't have to worry about missing any of my new videos. The topics of the series will include the mystery of jawlines, ice cream, oil changes on cars, how Americans and Germans handle having a cat, cookies and pastries, and also male circumcision. So yeah, I think Random Differences is a good title for the series. It's indeed a very random list and it includes a few juicy topics. And of course, after this little series, you'll get the usual long, in-depth videos again. But just because these are shorter videos also doesn't mean that I won't give you any background information. Of course, it's still me. So with that, let's get started. So what do I mean when I say Germans pee differently than Americans? Well, I actually just found out about this a couple of months ago when some friends and I were hanging out at the place of a German couple I'm friends with here in Cincinnati, and they have a sign in their bathroom that says, "Please take a seat," which to me as a German seemed totally normal. I didn't even really notice it. But then one of my American friends pointed out how German that is, and that's when I first learned that men in the US do not sit down when they pee. And yes, you heard right. This means that in Germany, it's pretty normal for men to sit down to pee.
Hey, ich warn dich, wenn du vorhast, hier aufs Klo zu gehen, dann setz dich fein bloß hin.
Now, there's more to the story, of course. Not every German man does this, and I'm sure there are some men in the US who do, but as a woman who doesn't really think about this topic ever, I was really surprised to find out that there was a cultural difference here. So I did some research and found out that in Germany, this is in fact a more recent development. So sitting down to pee for men has become more and more common over the past few decades. And obviously I'm not a guy, but I do remember that even in kindergarten, back in the 90s, the boys were taught that they're supposed to pee sitting down because that was considered like good manners, while standing urination was, yeah, almost like the rebellious way. Of course, those were kids, and I'm sure American daycares don't want little boys to pee all over the place either when they're standing. But even later, when growing up, you would see those signs in public bathrooms or at people's places to tell men to sit down. So it's definitely a thing in Germany, and if a man does sit down to pee, it's associated with good manners and showing respect. Does that mean German men never pee standing up? Nope, absolutely not. Obviously, standing is just way more convenient in a lot of situations, and a lot of men just prefer that over sitting down. And yes, of course, you will find urinals in public bathrooms in Germany, just like you do in the US. Now, when it comes to numbers though, I did find a statistic, and this actually surprised me because it said that only 50% of German men prefer standing urination. I would have expected it to be the majority, to be honest. And about 67% even said that they always sit down when they're at home. And the topic even made it into the worldwide news in 2015 when a German landlord in Düsseldorf demanded a payment of about 2,000 euros from her tenant because he had allegedly damaged the marble floor with urine because of his peeing habits. The court ruled in favor of the tenant though and said that he was indeed allowed to pee standing up because it's still a common practice. Now, from what I found out, this whole debate about standing versus sitting started in the 1970s and 80s in Germany during the women's movement, in West Germany to be precise, and that's when you'd start seeing these stickers on toilet seats everywhere. And as I said, since then, sitting down to pee for men has become more and more common in Germany and in other European countries as well. But apparently this wasn't and isn't really a thing in the US. And I have to say, logically, this doesn't really seem to make a lot of sense. Standing urination is just as messy in the two cultures. And if about 50% of German men actually prefer to pee sitting down, then why don't American men do it? Or maybe my American friends were wrong when they told me that it wasn't really a thing in the US. I have to say it's a little mysterious to me, so please help me out and let me know about your experiences in the comments below. If you're American, has this topic ever even come up? Were you ever taught to pee sitting down? Do you guys talk to your kids about it? And if you're German, what's your experience with this? Did you grow up with the premise that standing urination is bad behavior? Or if you're from somewhere else, what is it like in your country? Let me know. Before I wrap this up, I should probably mention that even though peeing sitting down is a totally accepted and encouraged thing in Germany, the myth that it's not very manly that a lot of people mention in this context does exist in Germany as well, and we even have an insult that's based on this. Calling a man a Sitzpinkler, a sitter or sitting weir, pretty much means that he's a wimp and not very manly, which is ridiculous on so many levels. I hope we can all agree on this. So this was the first topic from my Random Differences series. Now, please help me understand this, let's call it interesting cultural difference, by sharing your opinions and experiences in the comments below. And also stay tuned for the next Random Difference video in 2 days. And on a different note, let me know if you'd want me to make a whole video about this bathroom topic, because there's so much to talk about here actually. German and American bathrooms are different, the toilets are different, we use toilet paper differently, and so on. So if you'd like to learn more about that, let me know about that too. I hope you guys enjoyed this video about this interesting topic. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the thumbs up button. Follow me on social media for more behind the scenes content, and I'll see you in 2 days. Tschüss!